Hey. So it is Writing Wednesday, and I am LA Lewis, and I am here with your Wednesday writing tips. So this Wednesday's topic is five things I learned going from barely selling to best selling. So I'm gonna jump right in. The first thing I learned, character development. I learned how to really develop my characters, how to make sure my characters were believable, how to make sure my characters were 3D characters, meaning they have their flaws and they have their good sides. They're not all bad, they're not all good, because we are not all bad or good. We have our different attitudes depending on the situation that we're in. And not only that, we have our different personalities depending on the setting that we're in. At home, I am different than I am outside or at work. I'm not as laxed as I am at work, as I would be at home with my family. So I change according to my setting. Your character should change according to your setting. Don't let them be the same everywhere they go. Those are flat characters. They are not 3D characters, and you want them to be believable. Your readers need them to be believable. The next thing I learned was about, I'm sorry, I have it written down. The next thing I learned was types of editing. When I did my first book, I had one editor, which is fine. And this one editor did the two types of editing. I just didn't realize there were two types of editing. There's your developmental editing and there's your line editing. Now, it's up to you. You can get two different editors if you want. I did have two different editors for Double Down and Dirty, but it's not necessarily. There are some editors who can do both. There are some editors who can do line editing and developmental editing. So the difference, line editors edit for grammar, punctuation, spelling, you know, the typical editing. Developmental editors are editing to make sure your story makes sense. They're editing to make sure there are no inconsistencies in your story. They're editing to, you know, help you really develop this story. They're developmental editors. Their job is to help you develop a great story. So they also help with your characters and, you know, all of this great stuff. So that's your developmental editor. And your line editor, again, grammar, punctuation marks, spelling, all of that. Other than editing, the thing, I never heard of beta readers until I published my third book, or until I was working on my third book. Beta readers are readers who, A, are not your friends and family, because if your friends and family are like my friends and family, they're going to love it anyway. You know, no matter what you write, it's going to be the best thing they've ever read. So you want people who are going to be honest, brutally honest with you. If there's something they don't understand, you want people to tell you, I don't understand that. Why did you write that? Can you change this? This didn't quite make sense. What was the purpose of this? You know, if there's anything like that, the beta readers are going to tell you. It doesn't feel good, because some things they may say, I just didn't like it at all. I didn't like, you know, they may not say they didn't like the whole book, but there may be something in the book that they just didn't like. And it could be something that you just really love. So that's when you're asking, what was it that you didn't like in particular? So, you know, it's not that you have to take it all out. Maybe you just have to change it up some. So your beta readers, again, are people who are going to be brutally honest with you. You don't have this close-knit relationship with them, so they don't feel like they have to spare your feelings. They will tell you the truth. Find you three or four beta readers, let them read it, and then go, you know, make the suggestions or changes or whatever they suggest. So one was character development. That helped me. Two was the types of editing, and definitely the beta readers. Three is a street team, developing a street team. Street team, now these are your friends and family, because these are the people that's going to go hard for you. These are the people that's going to change their Facebook profile picture to your book cover. These are the people that's going to share. These are people that's talking about it, letting other people know about it. Letting other people know about it. This is your street team. You want to have a street team in place. So once you start marketing and promoting, they're starting to market and promote. The more, the better. My phone is running low, so I'm gonna hurry up. Four is to read all that you can while you're writing. Do not make the mistake that I make. made back in the day when I first wrote my first novel. I didn't read anything because I said, I'm not about to read. I'm not about to steal these people's ideas and accidentally put it in my book. That was a mistake. I should have been reading because I'm reading to learn. I'm reading to see how they develop their characters. I'm reading to see how they set the scene. I'm really just reading to see how they heighten their, you know, their plot and worked everything out and brought it all together. I'm reading to learn. Read, read, read. Trust yourself enough to know you will not steal their work. And last but certainly not least, marketing and promoting. Don't wait until it's time for you to start to put your book out, to start talking about it and promoting it. Do that early, like 6 months in advance if you can. Talk about it, share snippets from it, start a Facebook page about it. Just create this huge buzz about the book that's coming. And then when you actually start, you already built an audience who are waiting for your work. So don't wait. And another thing with marketing and promoting is budgeting. Oh my goodness, this one really got me because I didn't realize the money that I was gonna be spending. Writing the book was free. That was the only free thing. I had to pay to get it printed. I had to pay to, you know, get my copies to sell. I had to pay for a book cover. I had to pay editors, which is expensive. You really want to start saving your money, like right now, and put it aside because you also want to do events. You may want to go to festivals. You may want to go to workshops. You want to do things that's going to help you continue to, you know, enhance your craft. So you're going to need money. Remember, being a self-published author means you are a business and you need to treat yourself as such. You need money. Businesses need money to operate, and you are no exception to that rule, my dear. And neither was I. I found that out the hard way, but I learned now. So that's it. That's my five major things I learned going from barely selling to